Hello, replay viewers.
Happy Monday. What's up, guys?
Welcome.
Come on in the room. Casey, always the first to arrive. Hello, Casey. Casey, I'm going to be reaching out to you here in a little bit, and we'll talk about all the hashtag play 5 for 5 winners. But I'm going to be reaching out to get your contact information, all that good stuff. And the plan is to send out all the prizes. I need to get them packaged up, and there's some organization stuff that needs to happen. No worries, Dawson, but drumming is more important. I thought you were going to say, I got to sleep now, but I'll catch the replay. Oh my God, I can't wait. Thanks, Way. Dude, Casey, your video was so funny and captured the spirit of Lot Riot perfectly. I mean, there was another video that you may have seen. Hey, what's going on? Hey, guys. What's up, AJ? Hi, Kelsey, Andre. Good to see you guys. Keebs. Dude, aren't you tired from the weekend, Keeps? What's up? Nolan. Hey, Nolan, stay tuned. I want to show you something in just a second, but keep that in mind. Jumping onto beds is a lot, right? It's raining hard over here and the lights went out. I'm still watching the video. Thanks, Poppy. Hey, yes, but I wanted to tune in. Thanks. All right, guys. So there's a lot of announcement stuff that has to happen, but I also want to show you guys some stuff. I mean, there's more than I can cram in 5 minutes, so I'll be upfront about this. This is going to be a little bit longer than 5 minutes. Thank you for those of you who are coming in the room and tapping. If you swipe right and you hit share, that's always lovely as well. Watching this and doing an essay, awesome. No worries. And so this can be in the background as well. Hey, Garrett. Good to see you, bud. Thanks for inviting, Garrett. Appreciate that. Oh, my God. Another Casey. So here's the deal. A couple things to get started. First off, we're starting the week 5 of hashtag play 5 for 5. For many of the people who are in the room right now, you noticed that last time we did a hashtag play 5 for 5, except for it was a hashtag play 5 for 5 giveaway, which is always a good time. I'm actually gonna switch the phone around. I'm gonna try to do this without ending the scope. There we go. And which was fun, but guess what? This week, we're back to business as usual. We are on track to getting better and improving. And so if you caught the Sunday lesson yesterday, you know that this week's hashtag play 5 for 5 assignment is 16th note timing, 2 accents. And we're gonna tie this into yesterday's lesson, which talks about inner beats and timing. Timing is one of those things where you just need to kind of add to your routine. You know, I always equate timing and checking your slice, things like that. Hey, Beatle Percussion, welcome to the room, guys. Thanks for joining. I always equate timing and stroke and slice and all those things as being part of your maintenance. And what do I mean by maintenance? You know how every 3 months or 3,500 or 4,500 miles in your car, depending on the car and the oil that you use, you need to take your car in for maintenance. You have your 45,000 maintenance, you have your 60,000 mile maintenance, you have your 75,000 maintenance. You need to take your car in for maintenance. And timing, thank you for sharing on Twitter. I always love it when you see the share here and then it comes down on the phone. Appreciate that. You need to add timing as part of your maintenance. What's up, Hampton? What's up, Mr. Rodriguez? Hey, Hampton, Andre, Hampton. Diamond Bar in the house, represent, fellas. And so this week, we're gonna be spending it on 2-note timing. Thank you for the share, Garrett. We're gonna work on 2-note, 16th note timing. And then depending on how this goes this week, we might expand into some 2-note triplet timing as well. Now, if you caught Mark's lesson on Grid Book Series, from maybe 2 or 3 weeks ago, they talked about how even some advanced players don't work 2-note timing. It's like, whoa, this is a thing. Like, you need to be able to do this if you want to play some of the more complicated elements. It's always disheartening when you see a line that plays some crazy, difficult, choppy passage and they can't go, and then 4 and 1 rushes, or they come in early on beat 4, et cetera, et cetera. So it's important to make sure that timing is part of your maintenance. Okay, so I'm gonna start with some just 16th note, 2-note accent grid where I fill in the inner beats, and we're gonna add on to yesterday's Sunday lesson scope, which was titled "It's All About the Inner Beats." That replay will be posted on YouTube later, and then we're gonna break off into some actual 2-note timing. Okay, of course I've forgotten to bring a timekeeping device again, but we'll just feel it out. Okay, I'm gonna turn the accent off. I'm just gonna do this. Someone asked about the rhythm watch earlier. One of the things I like about the rhythm watch is when you turn on all the subdivisions, instead of having different sounds going off all the time, you have one consistent sound, and that's actually the sound that I'm going for when I'm playing on the pad also. Okay, so the first tempo. I'm gonna start at 80, okay? Here we go. Notice that if you're not careful, you might rush into the last one if you're going and a one, a two. You might rush and a one, so just be careful of that. Okay, here we go. Five more of those. Thanks for the hearts. Okay, so I did two sets of five and five. Now I'm gonna do the same thing, but I'm gonna take out the inner beats. If you didn't catch yesterday's lesson, Leslyn, it's all about the inner beats. So as I was playing that, I was really firm on my inner beats and making sure that I was trying to line up my inner beats with the metronome. And now I'm gonna continue to hear those inner beats in my head, but I'm gonna play only the accents. Okay, another set of five. Two things to notice that when you're doing the two note accents, you don't want the strokes to change just because the timing is different. Some of you may notice this as you're practicing, that when you do one E, the stroke should just be the same stroke as if you're just playing one note, but then when you shift to E-and, you wanna go. You don't want the stroke to change just because the partial is on a different beat. Left foot, heel, method, core, no, root on 2 and 4. Yeah, that's a good, can you type that one more time? I didn't think I got the whole comment, But I'm going to try that next in just a moment, which I think you said put the accent on 2 and 4. What I'm going to do next is turn off the inner subdivisions. And I'm going to move my feet. Even though I'm sitting down, move your feet. That's my problem, stroke types. No worries, Garrett. Just keep working on it. The main thing is to make sure you're just doing this in front of a mirror so you can see yourself or videotape yourself. Garrett, even better yet, join in on the Way 5 for 5, periscope yourself, watch your replay. Build the percussion. All right, so I'm gonna move my feet. Even though I'm sitting down, I'm gonna imagine that I've got a hi-hat and a bass drum going on. This is your equivalent of marking time, and I'm gonna try to fill it in. I think I need to raise this up just a little bit so I don't bump into my knees. 1, 2. One thing that will actually help if you do this with your feet, guys, is you hear the composite rhythm between your feet and your hands. Left foot heel toe method on quarter note, right foot 2 and 4. Oh, I see, you're drumming, so left doom, di, doom, di, doom, di, a doom, a doom, a doom, ch, sa doom, ch, a doom, like that. Nolan, I have a hard time writing time sitting down. Yep. You know, that's how I used to do it all through high school when I did my private lessons with my teacher. It's not ideal to stand. If you stand up and do it, it's even better. I've been on my feet all day, so I'm sitting down. Moving your feet is better than doing nothing. Okay, so back to hearing the composite rhythm between your feet. What I should hear is da 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 da, and then you should hear da 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 da. You hear 1 en, 2 en, 3 en. The next one would be 1 and a 2 and a 3 and a 4 and a boom, paka boom, paka boom, paka boom, paka. And the last one is boom, kapoom, kipoom, kipoom, kipoom. So hear the composite rhythm. I imagine that I have bass drums in my feet and I'm playing snare with my hands. Okay, let's take a brief pause here for just a moment, and let me show you guys what I'm working on over here. And let me start by saying, how many of us have checked out Gridbook Radio this month? Thank you for these hearts that are still flowing here. I want to make a point that I do go back and look at who's engaging, interacting on these periscopes, so thank you for those hearts. How many of us, can you just, okay, Garrett, you've checked out the Gridbook Radio this month. Me, this one with you, the one with you. Yeah, Andre, the one with me from this month. If you haven't checked it out, you can go into SoundCloud and just search Gridbook Radio. Well, actually, I think you search Gridbook Series. Well, I haven't had time yet, no worries. If you just need some homework music in the background, or maybe you're running or exercising, Mark has done a great job of curating the music this month. Thanks, Garrett. And there's going to be some more Marimba stuff coming out soon. Hampton, awesome. Hoy, the computer engineer. That's true. Electrical engineering was actually the engineering that I was working on. But if you haven't checked it out, check it out. And there's a little surprise at the end of the radio show. Spoiler alert, if you don't want to know what it is, then stop listening now. But for those of you who have already checked it out, at the end, I have a free gift that I sent to Gridbook Nation. And it's this practice journal that I use when I practice. This was, like, I actually made a sheet, but the concept was something that I used when I was auditioning for drum corps and when I was working my master's program. And basically what this is this is the example, and Nolan, you were joking about 217, but this is the example that I used, and I actually used it the week that I was working on touch, blend, and balance. And here, in my notes section, I'll explain how I format this in a section, but in the notes section, this is probably too small and with chicken scratch, you can't read it. But on my notes section, at the end of each lesson that I do, or each practice session, I wrote in my notes section, lesson number 7, Nolan wants me to go 215 beats per minute tomorrow. Nolan, that's you. So you made it into my practice notes from that week. My band director does something similar to get students in band to practice. Yeah, and really what it is just a way of organizing and systematically practicing. Like people think like, oh, you just practice and you just do it and you get better. Yeah, it is sweet, Nolan. And you have to be, you know, like thoughtful about how you practice. And if you really want to get good and make sure you cover all your bases, you have to be systematic about the way you practice, okay? So let me just run us through how this works, guys. Across the top, you see I have tempo markings. 92, 100, 108, and I think I go up by increments of 8 most of the time, but they're just some like target timing things in here. Yep. And then over here, what you should do is you should put the date, you should put what you're working on, and then target specific things. So for example, here in the example I wrote, because this is for Gridbook Nation, I wrote Gridbook, diddles 1-4, lines 1-4. And then here, you write out how many reps you're gonna do of each thing. Okay. Now, since today is the first day, and I don't know exactly which timings I'm going to do and how many reps I'm going to do, today's what I would call the baseline day. Okay. So the way I would set it, I'm going to do a fresh sheet here. So the first thing I would do is I write today's date. Today's 4/18. And the reason I'm taking the time to demonstrate this, guys, is this is a really simple concept, but just like everything else in life, the difference is some people take the time to do this, and other people don't. And not to say that you can't be successful without doing this. I know lots of people who are very successful that didn't go through this process. But if you're like me and you like systems and processes and you want a way of keeping yourself accountable, this is a very powerful tool on how you can do that. Okay, so today's 4/18. Time, this is really important. I got a question from Clinton today and he said, I'm having trouble balancing my practice time with real life and work and school. You can't just, and this is my tip for this, guys, you can't just practice when it's convenient. You have to set aside time to practice consistently because that's what's going to allow you to be successful. Okay? So for time, you're going to set aside what time you actually practice. And again, I didn't bring a watch, so maybe you guys could give me a time check here. I think it's like 8:30 over here, maybe. I'm going to say 8:30 to 9 p.m. Okay? And then the next thing is you list which items you're going to practice. Okay, so for me, the items that I have are 16th note grid, 2 accents, and then I have 2 accent without the 16th note grid, 2 accents, and 9/10. Thank you, Hampton. 2 accents. Okay, let's just restrict it to those two things because this is supposed to be a 5 for 5. I'm not going to practice. I'm going to practice more than 5 minutes. That's just the deal. 16th note, grid, 2 accents, 2 accents. Okay, and I just did that at 80 beats per minute, which is actually not on the chart, so I'd have to create another column for 80. And I did 3 sets in the beginning. I did 5, 5, and 5. So I did 15 sets of those. And then with just the accents, no feet, I did 10 reps. Okay, so 15, 10 reps. So guys, in like 5 minutes, I've already done 25 reps. There's no math involved with this. It's more of just like a tracking device. And what you're gonna see is if you track this over, I'll make this my sheet for the week, okay? If you track this over time, what you'll see is you'll see like, okay, today I practiced 80, I practiced 100, and then I practiced 120. And maybe this week, you over the course of the week, you're practicing the same stuff, but you hit different tempos, and then you'll start to see that certain sections are filled in, and you've got a grid of all the tempos that you've been practicing. Now, in case you didn't know this, you should practice tempos, all the tempos. Right, you should be able to master all the skill sets across a variety of tempos. And then if you're actually in marching season, you would want to actually practice certain exercises
for certain passages of music. Let's say you have show music at 180. Well, guess what? You should play the skill sets or the exercises that you need at 180 so it feels comfortable when it comes time to play the show music. Okay? All right, so we did 15 and 10. I'm going to do, how about 100 beats per minute? I'm going to do 10 reps with 16ths filled in, 10 reps with two accents only, and then I'll do 10 reps at 120 and 10 reps with two accents. Okay, so my chart looks like this. I did 15 just to kind of get into it, and then I did 10 with just the two accents, and I'm going to do 10, 10, 10, and 10. In the example that I showed up here, you can see that like maybe you don't do as many as you get faster, or if you know you're going to do many. And we'll talk about this a little bit more. This is a free handout that you can download, and the link is on the Gridbook. Good night, Logic Pro Gamer. Is on the Gridbook Radio show notes. So if you want a copy of this, it's a free download. Listen to the radio show if you like, and download this practice journal. Okay? All right, here we go. So I'm gonna crank this baby up to 100, and fill it in, okay? And I'm gonna do this with my feet also. Oh, sorry, I forgot to move this. See what's going on. Slow again. Did you guys see what happened? The first three times that I did it, I was slowing down gradually, and by the time I got to the third and fourth timing, I was slow. Stop your feet and you want be slow. Want to be slow if you stop your feet? Yeah, so I did two things to fix it. One thing is I recognized I was slow, so I played a little bit more on top of the beat. The second thing was I tried harder to feel the composite rhythm between my feet and my hands. And the third thing was I made a stronger effort to hear that was supposed to be going on my head, which wasn't. My bad. And I'm going to change this. I originally was only going to do 10, but I need to do another set of 5 because that wasn't very good. I'm going to do that again. All right, here we go. Okay, I'm gonna try one more variation where I fill this in. And I'm gonna make this beats 2-4. 1 and 2 and 3. These are the upbeats. 2. Actually, let's try this. Duck into two, three into four, one into two into three into four, one.
Not perfect, but it's getting better. All right, let's do one more. I think the other target tempo I set for myself was 120. And I'm gonna do 10 and 10 of these, okay? My second set of five, I'm going to flip the beat around, two and four.
One and a two and a three and a four and a one. Two.
Funny to watch people walk by outside who are walking their dogs, and they're like walking along, and they'll turn and they'll look in the lobby, and they do like a double take when they see me playing. Okay, next, same deal, taking out the inner beats. Actually, I'm gonna keep the inner beats in, but I'm gonna play two notes.
One, two, one, two. Thank you.
No inner beats. One, two. I don't know if you guys know, can you still feel that driving, even though I've only got it on this? Are you guys able to feel, yeah, okay, I can see it, either through hearts or in comments. Let me know, can you guys still hear? Yeah, because it's been on for so long, Vanessa, very good, that even when I turn it off, in my head, I can still imagine. And we only did it for like 10 minutes, right, guys? Like the metronome thing was only on for 10 minutes, but it's kind of been imprinted on your brain. You have an easier time imagining or hearing in your head. There's a word for that, audiate. You can audiate that auditory graph paper in your head. Height. Like think of all the things, depending on the show music that you're playing, that you should probably practice this at. What are some different combinations? Maybe you guys can throw some at me on variations on what you might practice with this. I just did 9 inches, right? It's straight timing. What if you did 3 inches? You could do visual volume. I missed it. That's a good tap exercise. It is. The point is to say is there's so many different things that you could be doing with this exercise. And I only did 3 different tempo markings, filled in, and not filled in. Nolan, 3, 6, 9, 12. Yeah, oh, that's cool. That's a good idea. What if we did this? So we'll do a rep of each one. Stuff that you could be doing with this. All right, so this is what I'm gonna do. Check it out. This, guys, are you ready for this? This is the most important part of this chart. Are you ready for the secret? For those of you who are watching this right now and those of you who are watching the replay, this is the gold that I'm about to share with you guys. Andre, you ready? No one ready for this. The secret to practicing is to plan out what you're gonna practice right after your practice session. In other words, I'm gonna write down what I'm gonna practice next time immediately following this practice session. If you're like, okay, why? Number one, it's fresh in your mind. All the stuff that you just did is fresh in your mind. The things that you need to work on, the stuff that you should be doing,
You have an idea of how many reps you should be doing of each thing. It's all fresh in your mind. Number two, kind of like homework, except for it's just called being smart. Because next time when you come back to practice, people, those of you who are like, oh, I'm busy because I've got track, and then I've got school, and then I've got my job, and then I've got to get home, and I've got to do my homework, and I've got to talk to my boyfriend or my girlfriend. I mean, like, you don't have enough time in your day, right? So literally, the next time you practice, you waste zero time going, oh, well, what should I do today, and what tempo should I, like, it's all mapped out. It's like Back to the Future. Those of you who have seen that movie, Back to the Future, you're going into the future, and you're writing this for yourself a note so that the next day when you practice, you go, hey, dear self, this is what you need to be working on today. I know. Such a good movie. Great music, too. All right. So I'm going to write 419. Check it out, guys. I'm writing this underneath. I'm making a note to myself of what I'm going to practice the next, your own drumming syllabus. Exactly, Nolan. So 419, I'm going to write out 16th note grid, two accents. I'm going to do it at... I'm gonna do two sets of five, so I'll do 10 at 80. And then I'll do one at two accents only. I'll do 10 of those. And actually, I like these tempos. I'll go 10, 10, 10, 10. So actually tomorrow, I'm gonna do the exact same tempos and the same times, except for, check this out, I'm making a note underneath. And this is the most important part, because the notes that you make for yourself, this is kind of like you're doing an experiment. You are the science fair experiment, right? And you're making notes, observations about your data. You're like, hey, I noticed you can put the metronome on 2 and 4, multiple heights. Nolan had a good suggestion about going 3, 6, 9, 12, maybe 15, and visual volume. I would also like to try practicing this 4-2-1, which I'll do tomorrow. And don't be slow at 100. Because I was slow the first time I did that. Okay? And check it out, guys. I mean, this doesn't have to be a work of art. This just has to be you taking note of what's going on. Now, notice that we're only operating in this part of the graph. Because it is 16th notes, probably you're going to make it up to like 160s, 170s, unless there's a particular passage which you need to play past into these tempos. But these tempos are still here because you might say, hey, in my practice session, I also want to work triplet two-note timing, at which point you would use these timings up here. Whew. Are you guys with me? Is this making sense? Or are you guys like, wait, you're insane. Just play the drums and stop talking, please. Vanessa, Casey, yeah. And guys, I'm telling you, I'm giving you like a very basic example of how you might use something like this. But if you use this format with a bunch of stuff of how you practice, let's say you're practicing Allstate music. Hampton's like, hey, I'm going to practice some Allstate music. And you have a particular passage of the music where you've got some thing that you're working on, and you or keep talking. And thanks, Hampton. Or you've got a thing that you're working on, and you make a note to yourself, and you say, hey, practice this, and maybe you want to scaffold your way up to it. Like, the target tempo is 180. You can't play it at 180. So you say, on Monday, I'm going to hit 150, 160, and 164. And on Tuesday, I'm going to do 150, 164, and 172. And then on Wednesday, I'm going to do 172, 176, and then 180. And then you do 184, 186, and 192. And then on Friday, you scale it back down to 184. You know, I mean, there's just... You've got to figure out what the best way to do it is for you. Thanks for the advice, Huey. I printed the PDF. I was a little confused. Thanks for clarifying. No problem. And as I'm using it, I think I would adjust some things. I think I might make this section a little wider, like where you can put the items and the target. You know, I don't know. This is always a work in progress. Usually, I just try to figure out a way to make this into a printable format so people could do it. Usually what I do is I just write this out in a notebook format. Like with all my private students, Hampton and Andre, you guys can testify to this. I do this in like, I get one of those lab notebooks that you can get at, you know, the CVS or any grocery store. And on my bookshelf, you'll see like volumes and volumes and volumes and volumes of lab notebooks. And I'll say like, hey, this is my lab, this is my practice journal from April through December, right? If it's a light practice month. Like if it's a heavy practice month, maybe it's a lab notebook just for 1 month. And I always write the date when I start it, and then when I finish filling it up, then I write the end date. And then I can see everything that I practiced over that period of time. And I used to do that every practice session when I was in my master's degree. And it's just a way of tracking your practice. The real value in doing this is not only planning out your practice, but you're gonna make little discoveries about yourself. As you're doing this, you're gonna be like, ooh, I just get an idea for something, and you write it down. Because if you're like me, if you don't write it down, it's like, it's gone, like that. So you have to write these things down. You say, oh, I noticed that when I practice with the 16th note setting on and I put the accent on 2 and 4, it feels a lot better. You write a little note to yourself. And then these little notes will help you practice. The other analogy I like to use with my students is if you've read or you've seen Harry Potter, there's an episode or one of the movies where he gets some potion book, and inside his potion book are a bunch of notes. Dust in the wind. There's a bunch of notes in his potion book, and all of his potions turn out better than the other students in the class, because it's like, instead of doing this, do this, right? I know this is getting way too nerdy. But it turns out that Harry actually has Snape's old potion book, and Snape added all these notes in the margin because he experimented and he found out, because of Snape's books, yeah. And then he found out, he added notes and made his potions better, and Harry has his potion book. Sorry, that analogy went too far for too long. The point is, if you do this, you'll make discoveries about how you learn and how you practice better. I cannot believe you guys are still watching this. You guys are amazing. Okay, let's get to the good stuff. Even though this wasn't already amazing. Week 5, #play5for5. If you happen to be watching this and you were one of the winners from last week, I'll be sending out messages this week to collect your contact information. I'll be boxing the prizes up this week. And probably next Monday is what I'm shooting for, is I will send all these packages out and then you will be happy. Second, if you didn't win one of the giveaway prizes, I've got a little bonus for you. You may have missed this announcement in yesterday's lesson, but I'll be going to my vlog #5 comments section. I'll be reading through the comments, and with the additional prizes that I've had left, I'll be selecting certain individuals who have been participating on Periscope and on Instagram and on YouTube and who have subscribed and followed, etc. I'll be choosing select individuals to be sending out select prizes for those as well. So for those of who are still watching right now, head over to YouTube. Thank you to those who are participating. I see those of you who are participating. Don't think that you're unnoticed. I am taking note. #3, and this is the last announcement for the evening. If you would like to win a Beetle floppy pad this week, if you complete this week's #play5for5, meaning you Periscope yourself practicing for 5 minutes on what we're doing, and I try to, did you kiss your wife for all the prizes? I did kiss my wife many times. I missed her and the whole family so much the whole time I was away in WGI Dayton. There was lots of I miss you kisses going on when I get back. If you complete this week's #play5for5, meaning you watch me do it today, tomorrow, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday. Let's say you start on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. You practice for 5 minutes for 5 days in a row. Periscope yourself. Make sure you use the #play5for5 so that I see it. Make sure that I'm following you on Periscope. So if for some reason I'm not following you on Periscope, just send me a message through Instagram. And if you actually fill out your practice log and you show us how you're using your practice log, if you do that, you'll be in the running and I will send you a Beetle floppy pad. If you saw in a couple scopes ago, I mentioned how I keep one of these in my backpack now. They're just so light, you know, and especially if I'm getting off of work or something, you can throw this on your countertop or outside and you've got an impromptu practice pad. It's light enough that it makes me not have to take it out of my backpack, because like sometimes when you've got a practice pad, the extra weight, you don't want to carry it, but this is so light. It's pretty awesome. So this is a 10-inch. Yeah, 10-inch, 1/4-inch rubber. And I'll be selecting one person. If only one person does this, meaning one person practices for 5 days in a row and fills out the sheet, guess what? That one person will win this pad. Let's say 5 people do it. I'll select one.
Or maybe it'll be like the first giveaway, where only four people do it, all four people do an amazing job, and all four people won a 30-minute Skype lesson. As a side note, Ashley, I did not forget about our private lesson. Let's set up a time, maybe Wednesday this week, we can get together and do our lesson. Matt, Ashley, Daniel, we did it. Alexis is saving his lesson for later. Okay, that's it.
Are you on address? Adderall? No, I'm not. Any other questions for the evening, guys? Thank you for the lovely hearts, guys. And had a good day today. Did you guys have a good day? Yeah. Okay. All right. That's it. I'll see you guys online, Instagram, YouTube. You're welcome. Thanks for watching, guys. Check out the YouTube channel. There's some more vlog content coming out from WGI last week. What I need to do tonight is, you're welcome, Skechers. Thanks for watching. Today's lesson was awesome. Thanks, Vanessa. I'm glad you enjoyed it. Hopefully these are helpful. You're the best, Nolan. Kelsey Drums, you're welcome. Thanks for watching, guys. Tonight, what I'm going to do is I'm going to message the Instagram winners. I'm going to finish the handouts for lessons 8 and 9. And there's one more big thing. I'm going to start to edit some of this vlog content from last week. So keep your eyes peeled for that. All right, guys. Thanks. Have a good night. We'll see you later. Bye, Hampton. Bye, Kelsey. Bye, Nolan. Bye, everybody. Bye, Andre. See you later, guys. Good night.